Namaste. I am Pratibhakini. Welcome back to my channel. Do you want to improve your memory? Would you like to know some easy tips and tricks to memorize your dance steps? Then this video has got you covered. In the first episode of How to Improve Memory, I gave you 6 effective methods to improve your muscle memory. If you haven't watched it yet, please go check it out later. I have enclosed the link in the description box below. Today, I shall tell you some changes that you can make in your lifestyle to better your memory and also some additional bonus tips to memorize the choreographies. So don't go anywhere and watch the video till the very end. Also, as many of you requested, I have made a playlist called a video sequence guide to help you plan your workouts. Do read the description of the playlist where I have explained elaborately. Should you need more guidance, do attend my strength and conditioning and yoga workshops, which I conduct every month. And I am thrilled to announce that admissions are open for online Bharatanatyam classes with different batches for different time zones. You will find the details regarding the workshops and my dance classes on my stories, community posts on YouTube, and also on my Instagram profile. Do check it out. So let's understand what is affecting our memory. And I shall try to suggest some lifestyle changes or solutions for each of the problems. The first problem you need to overcome is stress. Chronic stress can destroy your brain cells and damage the hippocampus, a part of the brain responsible for the consolidation of information from short-term memory to long-term memory, and affect the formation of new memory and retrieval of old ones. Depression and anxiety also affect concentration, remembering, and decision-making capabilities. Meditation is the best solution to reduce the stress level, and it indirectly helps you to improve your memory. Second problem is poor diet. Choosing the correct diet and eating right is also very important for memory. The fatty acid omega-3 are mainly beneficial for the brain. So include chia seeds, flax seeds, kidney beans, walnuts, and pumpkin seeds or fish if you are a non-vegetarian in your diet. Avoid overeating. Healthy diet plan is key to a healthy brain and hence better memory. Some foods have negative effects on the brain, impacting your memory and mood. So what are the foods you need to avoid? Processed sugar, refined carbs, foods high in trans fat. Try replacing them with foods rich in antioxidants. Include fruits and vegetables, leafy vegetables in your diet. Third problem is lack of exercise. Exercising increases oxygen to your brain and reduces the risk of disorders that lead to memory loss. It also enhances the effects of helpful brain chemicals and reduces stress hormones. So do exercise regularly. Fourth problem is lack of sleep. Lack of sleep impairs a person's creativity, problem-solving skills, ability to focus and learn efficiently. Sleep is necessary to consolidate a memory so that it can be recalled in the future. So improve your sleeping habits. Sleep on time and long enough to rejuvenate your body. I hope you're going to make these lifestyle changes, which will help you not only to improve memory, but also to lead a healthy life. Coming to the bonus tips as promised at the beginning of the video, here we go. Tip number one, attach a mental image or terminology to the step. For example, I had a student who had difficulty learning Jaradavu. She somehow couldn't remember the sequence of how her hand must move. So I gave her an analogy of flipping dosa on the pan. She could immediately relate to it, and now she has no problem performing flipping the dosa adavu. Likewise, the name of the adavu itself offers clues such as Yagaru Tattu, you jump and hit, Ranga Kramana, you cover the space or stage, and so on. But if sometimes you cannot relate to the name, give your own image or terminology, no matter how strange. Anything can be remembered if you associate it with some other facts that are already available in your mind. Tip number two, create a story in a language you're comfortable. There is no way you're going to emote well if you do not understand the lyrics. I am not well versed in Tamil. So when I learn an Abhinaya piece, I weave a story around it in my mother tongue so that I can remember. For example, say the story and dance first, then play the music and dance the same. For instance, again and again, he holds my hand. Do you know who he is? Dear friend. Tip number 3. Recollect the choreography or steps before bedtime. According to a research, the best time to study or learn information is before going to bed. As you sleep, your short-term memory converts into your long-term memory. Unless your brain identifies something as important to remember, it will tend to erase the memory when you sleep. By recollecting right before bed, the choreography is more likely to convert to your long-term memory. Tip number 4. Say the verbal cues aloud. Your movement may already be set to music. However, the dance itself has a rhythm or phrasing or some cues. Try to focus on this and even say it aloud or sing it to yourself when you practice or recall the movement. For example, while teaching Jaradavu, I give my students some cues which they can say aloud while practicing. Something like up, down, side, down, up, down, side, down. You could try doing it while practicing too. Tip number 5. Demo it or teach the step to your dance class friend. When you have to perform in front of someone or teach someone, you yourself must be confident about the technique. Doing so will make you remember whatever you've learned better. Last but not the least, don't copy your friend in the dance class. Many students depend heavily on the teacher for cues or other students while performing movements. When you do this, you're leeching the steps from someone else without actually retaining much of it in your own brain. So when that person is no longer performing the choreography or makes a mistake, you will be unable to perform accurately. So try to keep your focus off of those around you. Concentrate and pay attention when your teacher teaches it. Finally, know that you're not alone. You're not slow. Everyone learns differently. Never be afraid to explain to your dance teacher if you're not able to cope with the choreography and to reduce the pace for you. That's all I had for today. I hope you will implement these techniques to memorize steps. Don't forget to comment which tip you liked the best in today's video, and also let me know if you follow any other method to remember steps. Give me a thumbs up, click that like button, and do share this video with your friends who might find it useful. Be sure to subscribe to my channel to not miss out on the useful content I post every Saturday at 7 p.m. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next week.